Brennan Conway joins us with a look at what James Foley's friends are now doing to help him, new at 10.
Yeah, and Toya, Jim Foley has now been missing for 16 and a half days and counting. This website here, freefoley.org, is just one of the many ways that his friends and his Marquette family is trying to make sure that he comes home safely.
Our Father, who art in heaven.
Jim Foley's friends say a prayer for his safe return. With Foley missing thousands of miles away, the group is getting together in Milwaukee to do what they can.
We just hope that these prayers, you know, could be answered. You hope that maybe this media attention could kind of put some, you know, pressure.
Foley graduated from Marquette in 1996. He spent time teaching at-risk students before going back to school for journalism and spending the past 3 years reporting in the Middle East. On April 5th, Foley and three other reporters were covering the conflict in Libya when they were taken by pro-Qaddafi forces.
He's willing to try to find the story. He wants to report on stories.
No one has heard from Foley since, and his friends and family are looking for any information they can get.
There have been many secondhand reports, some incorrect, about his location and condition, but there's been no confirmation from the Libyan government.
Hoping to apply pressure, Foley's friends have taken to the internet, creating a website and Facebook page. Jay Carney, President Obama's press secretary, sent out a tweet this week saying they're working hard to assist Foley and the other missing reporters.
The mere fact that it's mentioned is great news. That it's not just being pushed aside.
Foley's parents, who live in New Hampshire, heard their son may be able to make a phone call in the next few days. It's far from having him home, but it's a start.
His parents are waiting on that, but it's not official, but it's hopeful. I mean, it suggests obviously he's still alive, which is the main thing.
And Foley's friends have also set up this online petition calling for his release and those other missing reporters. So far, their goal, 10,000, more than 5,000 people have signed up. If Foley is not released in the next few days, there may be a vigil at Marquette University sometime next week. Reporting live in the newsroom, Brendan Conway, WISN 12 News.